Yala Sangha,
welcome to day 28 of our 31 days. What I've been thinking about for today is that we're not doing a practice that's too demanding most of the time. We're especially physically, hopefully, you know, like we're doing a practice that is functional and useful. But there's a kind of slow build to it, right? We're slowly getting a little bit more mobile, a little stronger. When you meet my teachers, they're pretty unassuming, Mohanji and Indraji, you know, but they have this like quiet strength. Physically too, right? They're physically very like, they stand really tall, they're slight, but they're strong, you know, that there's images of Mohanji practicing in his 70s where he looks better than he did in his 20s. He doesn't show them very much though because he kind of keeps them just for himself and occasionally he shows some of his students. So we want this strength, okay? But it's quite, it's like a slow strength, you know, like, and actually slow movement, especially if it's a strength movement, is much more demanding than a quick movement. You know, like when you see people do like clean and jerks and all these kind of lifting movements, really the speed and the power that they can generate that gives them the ability to get things up over their head. But if they were to do it really slow, then it's a much harder prospect. I was watching a pull-up video on YouTube with my friend Hannah last night, and they were trying to pull up for a minute and lower for a minute, and virtually nobody could do it. It's demands so much strength to do something slowly, but we don't live in a society that likes doing things slowly. So anyway, let's come to all fours today. We're going to be a bit stronger today, so hopefully you are up for that. Not too strong. And as always, it's personal to you. You decide how much you want to put in, okay? If you're taking it easy, then you just go a little faster or a little less deep. Okay, so let's come to all fours and make your space suitable for you, okay? Let's do some spinal movement first just to get us started. Lifting into cat, lowering into cow, and just go between these two movements. Cat posture, cow posture. See how that feels. Maybe side to side movement, maybe making this skipping rope movement with your whole torso. Getting your body moving. Hello, Thompson. I think when he hears me, he's lying on my bed, and when he hears me talking, he thinks, oh, I should be here. I need to be in this movie, okay, or whatever we call it. Okay. So let your weight come back towards your heels. And then walk your hands back towards your knees and try your kneeling position today, okay? And see if you can step out with one foot and just lean into that a little bit, okay? And slide it back underneath, okay? And step out with the other foot. Don't worry if this is tricky for you. Don't worry about these things too much. It's just, and lean into that, okay? Try that one more time either side. From a kneeling position, stepping out and leaning in, okay? From a kneeling position, stepping out and leaning in, okay? And then back to kneeling, okay? Bring your hands forward again. Again, don't worry about things that you think, oh, that feels clunky and uncomfortable. It's with practice and time that things become less clunky. So bring your weight forward and have your spine kind of long, right? So you're not bunched up. So extend everything forward. And already we'll feel our arms stiffen and engage, okay? If we let them go soft, we're going to crash onto the floor. But slowly lower yourself to the ground. Now really take your time with this. If it's too strong, you just go less low. Okay? And before you touch the ground, slowly start to come back up. Good. And then let your hips come back towards your heels. So you feel in that, you know, like there's a lot more going on than maybe you thought. Okay, so let's try again. Repetition is a mastery of all skills. Remember I said that earlier this month? So slowly lowering down, not bunching up, keeping your head nice and relaxed, keeping your breath smooth. If you find yourself struggling, okay, then all you do is go a little faster or go a little less deep. Okay, and then let your hips again come back towards your heels. Good. Walk your hands back towards your knees, okay, and come to a kneeling position that feels comfortable for you. Okay, take your hands up over your head and bend your elbows wide and push your hands back up. Okay,
bend your elbows wide
and let them come back up. Now we're going to try and make that movement from a kneeling position and then a down
dog position, okay?
So think of where your arms are going. They're not out in front, okay? They're over your head and they're going wide, okay? So bring your hands forward. Try and get yourself in that position where your hips and the heels of your hands are in a line and bend your elbows wide like we did a moment ago and push away again, okay? So this is a little bit like the position we were in yesterday or last night for Anahata, but we're using it now to build a little strength. Okay, walk your hands back towards your knees and see how that feels once you've done a few of them. Now we're going to try it from down dog. If you know it's going to be too tricky, you keep with the knees in the ground, or even too tricky still, keep with a kneeling position and just make the movements. Okay, you can even add something, hold something in your hand like, I don't know, a tin of beans or something. Okay, tuck underneath your toes. Let your hips come back towards your heels. And float up into downward facing dog. Pedal out your down dog. Get comfortable in your down dog. And then from there, move your chest a little closer to your legs. Your knees can be soft, right? Don't think about your knees. Your legs have to be super straight. And then from there, bend your elbows wide and push the floor. Okay. Bend your elbows wide and push the floor. Okay, try that one more time. Or two more times. Good. And last one. Slow movement again is going to make it a little bit stronger. And then let your knees come down. Walk your hands back towards your knees and come to a kneeling position again. Hopefully kneeling has gradually got much more comfortable over the month. What we can also do is we can start to, rather than come down right in the center, is see if we can lean slightly to one side as we come down. So bring your hands forward again. Okay. Again, you can do this very slowly if you feel quite strong, or you can do it a little faster if you are a little less deep. But bring your weight slightly over one hand, maybe your right hand, and come down towards the floor. And then push back up. Okay. Try and shift your weight slightly over your left hand. And come slightly down. And slowly back up. Okay. And move your hips back. Now, if you're finding this, you're like, Mark, man, this is so tricky for my practice today. Bring your hands a little closer, right? Okay. And come down from here. And shorten the lever, right? Okay. If you're finding it so easy that you're like, this is bread and butter for me. I don't think I've ever used that phrase in my life. Take your toes back and shift your weight slightly over one side for your bread and butter practice and come down. And come up and come over the other side and come down and come up. Okay, and then let your knees come down. Walk your hands back. Let's give our arms a wee rest, roll through our shoulders. Okay. We also want to be strong in our back too.
Okay. So what you can
do in the back of our body is come here, let your legs go a little straighter. Okay. You can use your hands on a couch or on a bench or something and just push down and come up.
Push down and come up. Okay, we can come to a posture called Parsvottanasana, where we'll do it half first. So bring your foot flat and lift up your hips and do a little dip here. Okay, you might feel your triceps. Good. Bring your hips come down, switch to the other leg. Lift your chest, little bend of your elbows. Okay, see how that feels, and then lift your hips. And then try and bend your elbows. Good. And down, okay.
Give your arms a wee shake off, your legs a wee tap up and down. Roll through your shoulders, okay. Let's try one more time with both legs straight if we can. Everything is optional, right? These are suggestions, okay. Lift your hips
up, chest up, bend your elbows, and push back up. Bend your elbows, push back up. Let your hips come down.
Give your wrists a shake off, your shoulders a shake off, okay. If your arms are getting super tired, then keep things quite short when we're going to strengthen around the back of our body a little bit, okay? Bring yourself to all fours again. See how that feels. Lift and lay your hands, lift and lay your knees. Maybe walk around a wee bit to crawling position. Take slow breaths in and out. And extend out through your right leg. So there's a really famous marathon runner, many of you will know, called Kipchoge, Eliud Kipchoge. And one of his favourite movements to strengthen the back of his body is this movement here. He bends his knee, okay? It's actually in the first chapter of my, the first book of my yoga teacher's first book called Yoga for Body, Breath and Mind. But lift your hips up a little bit higher, okay? And then lower your hips, and then lift your toes a little higher. And if you touch your buttock with your opposite hand, it might feel quite strong and engaged. Lift a little bit higher, lift your chest. Okay, and then bring your knee forward to your elbow. Bring it back again, reaching your toes up, and then forward again. Reaching up, good, and then forward, reaching up. And then let your knee come down, okay? Move your hips from side to side. Okay, try that another side. Extend through your leg. Bend your knee so your toes come towards the ceiling, okay? Lift your knee a little bit higher. Lower your hips. Lift your toes a little higher, okay? If you want to touch that opposite buttock, you feel your glutes engaged, okay? Raise the toes a little higher. Keep the hip low. Feel your butt and your hamstrings. Take an inhale and exhale forward. Inhale up again. Exhale forward. One more time. Inhale up. And let your knee come down. It's very easy for the position of that to kind of go askew. And let your hips go from side to side. Make that pelvis movement we were making earlier. And then reach out with your right leg again, okay? Bend your knee underneath, but don't let your foot touch or your knee touch the floor. Take your knee a little higher, okay? And let it come down. Higher. It's a bit like Thompson when he's out and he sees a tree that he likes. Okay, lift your knee. Let it come down. This time lift your knee, but extend your foot out. And see if you can bring your toes forward. And then slightly back. Forward, slightly back. Forward, slightly back. Forward, slightly back. And then take your leg back. Okay? And then let your knee come down. And move your hips from side to side. So to get stronger, it's fairly, you know, we just make a movement and we add a little more resistance to that movement. Okay? You know, everybody knows how you strengthen their biceps. You curl your bicep. And the stronger you want to get that area, you add more weight, okay? So let's try the other side. Extend through your left leg. Reach a little bit further, okay? Bend your knee so it's coming down underneath. So it's not touching the floor. And we lift it up. And we let it come down. We lift up. We let it come down. We lift up. Let it come down. This time lift it up, straighten out through your leg. Okay, try and take your toes further forward. Keep your leg parallel to the floor. Toes forward. toes forward and then extend the back and let your knee come down. Move your hips from side to side, your shoulders from side to side. Make some cat and cow movements, side to side movements. Good. See if you can do, I mean, it's good to move dynamically too. So rather than always slow, okay, that's what gives us sometimes a bit more power in our movement. And so bring your hands a bit closer, hop to a squat. Okay. Hop it back, in and out. Okay. Send your hips into your squat. Seeing how your squat feels today. Take something underneath your heels if that's how you like your squat today. And just hang out in a squat for a bit. There's a really influential movement teacher called Ido Portal who encourages squatting for about 30 minutes of your day. Now, not all at the same time, okay? What he says is, like, you know, maybe when you're going to use your phone or take a call, you come down into a squat and you hang there. See how your squat's feeling. For some of us, the heels might never come down. Just depends on the shape of your body. I think for many of us, we probably can, though, including myself. I think I have to do a little bit more work on that this year. Good. I'm gently rocking backwards and forwards in my squat. And then bring one hand down inside one leg. And inhale, open up with the other hand. Exhale down. And he'll open up on the other side. And exhale down. One more time, either side. And he'll go in tall, reaching. Exhale down. And he'll go in tall, reaching. Exhale down. Shift your position to a seated position. Shake off your legs to begin with. Get them nice and loose after that squatting. Tap them up and down. Make ankle rotations, always with our mobility. You know, like, little and often is, I think, the key to our practice this month. We don't force things, we don't fight things. Remember what I said yesterday. Mohanji says that a practice is not a fight, okay? Yoga is not a fight. It's a pleasant experience. What they say is easy asana, which is the physical practice, pleasant pranayama. Bring your legs in. Bring your cushion to rest underneath your hips. You know, I like my little rug underneath my ankles. I'm getting soft. Don't know if I was ever not soft. Come in here. I think I would make these videos anyway, even if it was only me that watched them or looked ever seen them. They're kind of just kind of amuse myself. It's a bit ridiculous. Okay, let your hips rest on your heels. Let your shoulders soften. And let your breath slowly come in and out. And let your attention focus upon the slow flow in and the slow flow out of your breath. See if you can see if one nostril is slightly more dominant than the other nostril. So maybe you notice that one nostril might feel a bit more blocked than the other. If you notice any resistance in your body, Let your shoulders soften, your face soften, maybe your belly soften, your jaw soften. All these areas that sometimes the resistance and the tension and the stress of our lives sneaks into. And notice where your mind has just been. Quite often, we're so lost in our thoughts, like I said yesterday, that we don't even realise that we've sunk into thoughts and about this and that. Come back to your breath. If you've got time to stay here longer. If life has got in the way of your practice, then allow yourself some movement. Yala Sangha. Be kind to yourself today. Be kind to whoever else comes across your path.